This is Mando Loco.
Yes.
Hello, we're at Warner Brothers here in the costume department. Helen's not here, unfortunately, so she didn't want to come this year for some strange reason. So we've got another presenter to help us.
Hello.
Lucy, she's a bit of an expert on Star is Born. I've not seen it. You've seen it, haven't you, Mike?
Yeah.
You love it. You like it?
Cool.
So can you tell me some of these things. What's this? This is
the dress that Lady Gaga wears in the final scene. So, spoiler alert, but he dies.
Oh, right.
She uses a song he writes to sing that she'll never love anyone ever again because he's dead. And, yeah.
Blimey. And then,
That's what he commits suicide with.
Oh right, that's
yes.
It.
Yeah.
He hangs himself.
Yeah, I think those are glasses he wears, and I'm guessing because he's a rock star, so he.
There you go. Mike, that's the kind of thing you need if you ever consider.
Oh my golly.
Doing yourself in. We've got some other stuff here. What's that?
Yeah, she wins a Grammy in the movie, so she obviously this is her Grammy sort of.
Very cool.
Oh, this is the song he writes. So he's in rehab whilst he does this. And this is like the actual person taking these scribbles on and finds.
You've seen this, Mike, you know this as well. Let's have a look.
Oh, also that thing at the front, that little wire, he makes out of like a thing in the kitchen and proposes to her when he's at their house.
Cool. Read the lyrics. What's it say? Don't want to feel another touch. Don't want to start another fire. Before. Don't want to know another kiss. No one, what's that?
No other name falling from my lips. Don't want to give my heart away to another stranger. Don't let another day begin, won't even let the sunlight in. Oh, I'll never love again.
There you go. Sounds good. And then there's this one over here as
oh,
well.
Oh, yeah. So this is the Grammy dress she wears.
Look how short she is.
Yeah.
Tiny.
So I think she's only 5'3".
Is she?
Yeah. That's what I thought, yeah. But yeah, so this is, yeah, doesn't he get up on stage and he's really drunk and like he pees himself next
to her.
Yeah,
is that not the costume there or is that not the piss costume, surely?
No, I think that's the costumes when they first meet.
Oh,
So she's performing in a drag bar, so that's why she's got false eyebrows.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And yeah, so she's singing Love Your Rose. And then
and that's when she's, I've seen that clip and she's
lying.
Yeah,
she's lying on the bar.
Yeah.
And then this is the outfit he's wearing, I'm guessing, and then he gets up on the stage and performs a little.
What's this, Jack? Thing. Is his name Jackson?
Yeah, his name.
So that's his fake stuff.
Yeah, Jackson's name, yeah. They're like a really famous rock star.
Oh, right.
So he drinks to like deal with the pain.
Well done, Lucy. Well, that's good, isn't it? Lucky she was here. Helen, you let us down. No, you didn't. I know you can't make it. Thank you, Lucy. That was very helpful. Brilliant. Excellent.
Cool.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lucy.
Brilliant.
We've just found another expert, Tina, here. She likes the film. So,
hi, everybody.
So you watched all four of them this week?
I have watched all four of them this week. I had seen the Judy Garland one and the Barbara Streisand one before, but I just wanted to do a comparison from start to finish, so I started the Janet Gaynor one from the 30s. I love all four of them, but I think the fourth one, to me, is the best. The Bride of Blubber, Lady Gaga. I think they go a little bit further into their story, and there's a whole bunch of different aspects of it that you can relate to in some type of way. They're not just focusing on, you know, his alcoholism or her rise to fame. It's like their relationship, there's his relationship with his brother. So there's just a lot more to it. And it's just, I think, more clear on their points.
There's something about, like, Lady Gaga and her dad or something in the film, is
yes,
that?
Yeah, the relationship between her and her dad and even her dad's friends that he works with. There's so many different dynamics going on that it's,
I've really
it's
got
just
to see
amazing.
The film.
You have to see
I've
it.
See
it's
the
really
film.
And then the music, they say, is even a character in the story. Like, each of these songs, if you actually listen to the lyrics of them, they tell a story as in guiding along with the movie and where they're at that time. So it's very interesting.
Did Bradley Cooper sing all that stuff and play?
He did.
You did?
Yes. Yeah, he
Annie Doris.
Trained his voice
wow.
to even go like octave lower
oh, right.
to get that Jackson Maine sound.
Because that's like, they did real festivals and stuff. I think
yes,
I played
Glastonbury
in England.
Yeah, yeah, they would get up on stage and then they would perform their scenes, and it was so cool the way they did it. They didn't do it from the audience point of view, they did it from the singer's point of view.
Yeah.
So they actually took you on stage and everything you were seeing is what they were seeing,
oh,
them looking out into the audience. Her making that decision to get up and go sing on stage, which is just kind of a brilliant moment, which kind of starts everything. So I kind of like the way they took the cameras and kind of showed you like the gritty, you know.
Oh, give it a watch. It's probably going to be our plane
yeah,
on the way
Give it a watch. You have to give it a watch.
And I reckon Oscar best Best song?
It had my vote.
Film, you reckon?
I would recommend best film. I just absolutely loved it. I can't say enough good things about it.
Well, thank you very much. It's very nice talking to you, Tina.
Nice
thank you. Take
too,
care. Have a nice day. See you later.
It's Lady Gaga's house.
Lady Gaga's house. What happens here? This is where she lives with her dad.
Yeah, and is it his three friends or whatever? Yeah. And this is where she is picked up by Jackson's taxi and chauffeur to go to the airport.
There.
Yeah.
Space waiting for him.
Yeah. I think that's her room up there as well.
Oh, right. Cool.
Yeah. It's on the left.
There we go. Could be, Oscar song next tomorrow? Could be, no? You want more than that, don't you?
I think it's going to get like Best Picture.
That's what you want, Best Film.
Mind you, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Let's see how it goes. Well, there he is. That's
Best
impressive.
Actress, Lady Gaga. There we go.
Cool, let's go.
This is the building that the Grammys happen. This is where Lady Gaga, aka Ali, wins Best Newcomer.
The end of the film,
it's a bit, it's more like three quarters.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, this is before he goes into rehab.
Oh, right.
So, yeah, then Jackson, who's like drunk, he like crawls up on stage and wets
also
himself.
The other thing they used, I mean, this has been used for a lot of things, the carts he played here. Lots of people played here, loads of people played here, but Michael Jackson did the Pepsi advert here where his barnet went on fire, where his hair caught on fire and he lost all his hair.
Oh.
And he's completely bald Michael Jackson after that. So that happened in here, and so did Star Is Born. Oh, and the other thing as well, I didn't know if you know this, Lucy, but the only thing I know about this is the Judy Garland Star Is Born was filmed all in here.
1954 movie.
Oh, well, I didn't know that. That's good. That's impressive. So, and they filmed, I think they filmed the end of it as a tribute to Judy Garland. There you go. There you go.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Cool.
Well done, brilliant.
Hello, so this is the supermarket where Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper sit. So it's about here, was it? Yeah. And so it's after the fight in the club where they first meet. So Lady Gaga has punched a guy and they've gone to get peas, frozen peas for her fist. And she sings here because she reveals that she's a songwriter and that she writes songs. And then, so this is like the first edition of Shallow.
The Oscar-winning song.
Oscar-winning song.
And they were sitting on some sort of...
Yeah.
It's like that bump there, but they put one in. A little bump in here for them to sit on.
Yeah.
Amazing, so that happened here. Yeah.
Awesome. How's the song go, Lucy?
Oh. I'm off the deep end, watches out of it. I'll never meet the ground. But higher.
Wow. Brilliant.
Cool.
Wow.
Hey, is Mando Loco?
Yes.
Yeah, go.
Okay, so we're still at the Biltmore. This is another kind of location that's using the Star Is Born. Tell us about it. Tell us about it, Lucy.
So she has a job working at the hotel as like a waitress. And she comes out, I think she's just like quit. And she comes out and she sings Somewhere Over the Rainbow from Wizard of Oz, like All in the Night and echoey.
Oh my god, look, Lucy, that's it, isn't it? Isn't that where she works?
Oh my god, it's a big photo. So Lady Gaga walks out there and she sings Somewhere Over the Rainbow, which is a homage to the 1954 film of A Star Is Born that Judy Garland was in, which she sung in A Wizard of Oz, so yeah.